Hello students of class 7, today we'll start with the chapter rock and soil. So what is a rock? The rock is actually an aggregate of minerals of different types in varying proportions occurring in the natural conditions. So what is a rock? Rock is actually an aggregate of the minerals that we aggregate means it is a composition of different composition of different kinds of the minerals that are present and form one rock. Okay, this minerals we can get in the naturally and all the materials that make earth crust we call it as the rock. Okay, the rocks can be classified into three groups specifically, or three types. What are those? Number one, it is the igneous rock, then the sedimentary rock, and the last one that we have is the metamorphic . So these are the main three types of the rocks that are present on the earth surface, and this classification of the rock is based on the way of formation of the rocks, the way the time when this rocks has been formed. Based on that, the name has been given. Now let us see the first type of the rock, that is the igneous rock. The igneous rock is also known as the primary rock also, because this is the first formed rock on the earth surface. So because the igneous rock has formed first on the earth surface, so this is also known as the primary rock. So initially, when the earth was this ball of fire, consist of hot bubbling molten materials which are made from different elements and compounds. So with time, the heavy molten material started shrinking at the center of the earth, and those materials which are lighter are present near the surface of the earth. So all the materials that were heavy sinked into the central portion, and the lighter materials are present in the upper portion of, or the upper layer of this earth. Okay, so with time the upper layer of the earth, means this upper layer of the earth, cooled down because of the difference of the temperature, and the molten volatile materials that are present over there solidified to form the rocks, which is known as the igneous rock. The word igneous, or the word igneous rock, this word igneous came from a Latin word ignis, which means fire. So because this rock has formed from this fiery origin itself, that is why it is known as the igneous rock. So example of some of the igneous rocks are like granite, then we have the basalt, etc. These rocks are very much hard and resistant to erosion. This igneous rocks can be classified into different groups based on place of origin, means where they have formed. So basically it is being divided into two groups, the extrusive igneous rock and the intrusive igneous rock. So extrusive igneous rocks means the rocks which has formed in the outer part of the earth, and this one means the intrusive igneous rocks means the rock which has formed in the inner part of the earth. So these rocks have again been classified into different groups, like the lava rock, then the pyroclastic rock, then we have the plutonic rock and the hyperbasal rock. So this is the end of this video. I'll continue with the next of the portion in the next video. Thank you, everyone.